This week, India woke up to news that several of its citizens, including union ministers and opposition leaders, were being spied upon. Pegasus, as we all know by now, was used to gain illegal access to the phones of over 50,000 people, including presidents, prime ministers, politicians, human rights activists, journalists, and even heads of various private companies across the world. But the world knew about Pegasus way back in 2019 when security breaches were reported. What has changed now? And whom do we hold responsible? I am Akram Mohammed and I am going to decode this for you.
Not a shred of evidence has come that in this entire Pegasus story there is any linkage of the government or the Bharatiya Janata Party.
Our phone is totally tapped. Not only tapped, it is just like a recorder. They are behaving.
In the past, similar claims were made regarding the use of Pegasus on WhatsApp. Those reports had no factual basis and were categorically denied by all parties, including in the Supreme Court.
The Pegasus scandal broke just ahead of the monsoon session of the parliament. And as you just heard, Ashwini Vaishnaw, Union Minister for IT, Electronics and Communication, whose number was also allegedly breached, defended the government and flatly denied the possibility of snooping. He insisted that even WhatsApp had denied the possibility of snooping using Pegasus. But is that correct? In 2019, head of WhatsApp, Will Cathcart, tweeted to acknowledge the threat from Pegasus. After the expose this week, he tweeted to reiterate his fears regarding the spyware, which he said was used to commit horrible human rights abuses all around the world. According to Cathcart, the true scale of abuse today is even larger and with terrifying national security implications. So what was Union Minister Ashwini Vaishnaw on about? Another defense employed by the government was that the presence of a number in the leaked database does not mean it was snooped on. But forensic analysis of some iPhones that appeared in this list show signs of tampering caused by Pegasus. A hack using Pegasus is virtually untraceable in Android phones, according to the expose. In India, the leaked database of over 300 targets include politicians, journalists, rights activists, scientists, and even a sexual harassment complainant who had accused ex-Supreme Court Chief Justice and Rajya Sabha member Ranjan Gogoi of sexual harassment. The report also says that Pegasus was used to snoop on Congress and JDS leaders in Karnataka before the collapse of the coalition government in 2019. Who could have authorized this? Remember, the NSO continues to say that the spyware is sold only to vetted governments. When the issue first surfaced in 2019, the Indian government had said that no unauthorized interception was done. The government's response to an RTI query in 2019 did not deny the purchase of Pegasus. Even now, the government has not categorically denied that the spyware was used for surveillance in India. Which brings us back to the same question. Who deployed this cyber weapon against Indian citizens? The circumstances surrounding the use of the spyware may actually point to the government despite its denials. The Israel-based NSO group refuses to answer whether the Indian government is a client. As the expose shows, most of those targeted are on the wrong side of the government and some of them have been subjected to harassment. Only an independent investigation can reveal who is responsible for this hacking and surveillance. If the government has no role in it, it should be of special interest to find out who was conducting such large-scale illegal snooping in the country. It has a bearing on national security and cannot be dismissed as a conspiracy. The privacy of journalists, opposition leaders, constitutional officers and ordinary citizens cannot be violated. And more importantly, a democracy cannot function under surveillance.